pace of play is having a big impact on people's enjoyment of the game, of course, and it's actually a very good opportunity for golf course superintendents to contribute to the effort to reduce the time it takes to play. And we do that by helping in terms of how a course is set up and how a course is maintained.
Nobody likes losing a golf ball. When you lose a golf ball, it slows everybody down. And so that goes directly to the height of cut on your rough.
If you can do things to make it easier for people to find and advance their golf ball when they hit it outside of the fairway, which is very often for most of us, that would have a huge impact on pace of play.
The amount of rough mowing, it's a very delicate balance, especially on a modest budget golf course. And it's not usually the cutting height, it's the cutting frequency. Because on modest budget courses, it's not uncommon that they can mow over the rough once a week. So the turf that was mowed on Monday or Tuesday is very tall for the Saturday and Sunday golfer.
Way of getting around it is not mow all of your rough more often, but mowing a cleanup pass around the primary rough areas or the most in-play rough areas an extra time or two during the course of a week.
Minimizing the input, such as water, fertilizers, and occasionally using growth regulators will allow these lower budget courses to mow on a less frequent basis, yet enable them to provide roughs that are not too high for golfers finding their golf ball.
If you have severely contoured greens and really fast greens, that's going to make it much slower to play, much more challenging to play, and perhaps even unfair.
Every course is different, and so green speeds, they aren't all the same. These are not an apples-to-apples comparison from golf course to golf course. But it's green speed combined with where they're putting the holes. And if that combination is set properly, you can get golfers through a golf course. But if you set up either one of those wrong, you can have a long day of golf.
We visit a lot of courses that they're trying to just maintain extremely high putting green speeds, and that really increases the round. For the average golfer, it's not uncommon that a higher handicap is going to four putt a green that's at 11 or 11 and a half.
Anytime the putting greens are too fast for the contours, golfers not only have a challenge putting, but they also have a challenge chipping and making pitch shots around the putting greens. So now they're all of a sudden hitting two or three chip shots around the putting greens. Their frustration level goes up, the frustration of the golfers that they're playing with goes up, and the pace of play increases. So not a great situation.
There's definitely ways that we can use a lot of common sense to make the course more user-friendly for the people that are using it.
Having narrow fairways or misaligned fairways and narrow approaches tend to single out and penalize the higher handicappers, and it takes away play options for them. Choosing easy hole locations obviously makes a lot of sense. But the other thing to consider is on certain holes, like a par 5 that might be reachable, or perhaps a short par 4 that might be reachable, you may want to move the tees back on those holes so that it is not reachable for the majority of the players, so they don't have to wait for people to clear the green to hit their tee shot or perhaps their second shot on a par 5.
We encourage clubs and golf courses to incorporate naturalized areas or native areas.
Finding a balance between installing naturalized areas is something a lot of courses are struggling with.
Some courses, when they install them, have them so close to play that golfers are frequently hitting balls into them, and that can really slow up play. So consider the pace of play issue as you place your naturalized areas.
Another issue is the density of the naturalized areas and the kind of vegetation you choose. If it's not dense and you can go in and find a ball, the players can play on. If they hit it in there, though, and they can't find anything, they're going to spend extra time searching for their ball.
This is a work in progress. Oftentimes, as you set boundary lines to let areas become more native, you'll find sometimes that an area that maybe you didn't think was a high play area is a high play area, and these areas have to be adjusted out so they don't become so penal, because we have to remember that we're keeping the 15 and 20 handicapper in mind and not the single digit handicapper.
We can make golf a much more fun game, be much more efficient to get through a golf course, and players don't have to invest so much time in their day to enjoy a round of golf.